Okay, in Solution Explorer, right-click models and add a new class here. I'm going to call this movie. We give it a couple of properties, like integer ID and string name. To quickly create a property, just type prop, press tab. This is a code snippet. You specify the type, then press tab again, and the name of the property. So this class is a plain old CLR object, or POCO, which represents the state and behavior of our application in terms of its problem domain. In this case, it doesn't have any behavior or logic. It just has a couple of properties, which we use for representing state. Now, let's say we want to create a page where we randomly pick a movie and render its details. Assuming that this page would be under /movies/random, we need to create a controller called moviesController with an action called random. So, in Solution Explorer, right-click controllers, add controller. Here we have different templates, and most of them are used for auto-generating some code, which we call scaffolding. But we are not going to use any of these templates because I want you to learn how to create a controller from scratch. So, select the first one, add, call this movies controller. So this controller is a very simple class that derives from the controller class. And here we have an action called index, which returns action result. I'm going to change the name of this action to random. So this will be called when we go to /movies/random. Now in this method, I'm going to create an instance of our movie model. So movie, new movie. Now, because I'm using ReSharper, ReSharper automatically resolves the namespace for this class. If you're not using ReSharper, you need to go on top of this file and manually type using vitly.models. Back here, let's set the name of the movie, Shrek. In a real-world application, we often get a model from a database. But for now, to keep things simple, let's just focus on the core building blocks of MVC apps. Now here you can see that this method is returning a view. And the reason this view is red is because ReSharper is telling me that this view file does not exist in the application. So in the Solution Explorer, under Views, look, inside Movies folder, we don't have a view called Random. So right click, add, view, call this random. Here we have template, which we can use to auto-generate a view, but we're not going to use this feature. Under options, we can tick this box to create this view as a partial view. A partial view is not a complete page. It's like a widget that we can reuse on different views. We are not interested in that, so untick. Here we have a checkbox for selecting the layout for this view. A layout is like a template or a master page. We want all the views in our application to have the same look and feel. So let's select the layout. By default, our MVC project has a layout under Views, Shared, called Underlined Layout. So select this and add the view. Okay, here you see a mixture of HTML and C# code prefixed with an at sign. So on the top, we have a block, and inside this block, we are setting two properties. One is viewBack.title, which we'll look at later, but basically this is going to be the title of our page shown in the browser. And next, we're setting the layout for this view. After this code block, we have just plain HTML. Now I want to go back to the controller, press Control and Tab. This way we can switch between open tabs. Look, view is no longer red, because now we have a view on the disk. Now, I want to put this model, movie model, in our view so we can render it. Again, Control-Tab to go back to the view. I want to change this heading and render the name of our movie. So we need to write C# code. We start with @ and then type model. Every view has this property which gives us access to the model we pass to it in the controller. Now in the IntelliSense, note that the type of this model is dynamic. It's not a movie. So if I use the dot operator, I cannot see the name property of this movie here. So on top of the file, we need to use a directive to specify the type of the model for this view. So @ model, and this has to be lowercase. And here we specify the fully qualified name of our model class. So the name of the application, vidly.models.movie. Now, if you're using ReSharper, you don't have to remember this fully qualified name. You can just type movie and press enter. ReSharper automatically resolves the namespace. Okay, back here, now we can type model dot. And look, we've got ID and name properties here. So let's render the name. All right, now let's run the application. Because we are in the random view, and this view is inside the movies folder, if we press Ctrl and F5 now, our browser will take us to /movies/random. So Ctrl F5. Okay, congratulations. So you have seen a model, a view, and a controller in action. Throughout the rest of the course, we'll work on more sophisticated scenarios, but the fundamentals will be very similar to what you have seen in this video.